Blackstone Audio presents Secret Weapon, How Economic Terrorism Brought Down the U.S. Stock Market and Why It Can Happen Again, by Kevin Freeman. This book is read by Tom Weiner. Humbly dedicated by faith to God Almighty, that by His Spirit, because of His grace, He might be glorified. Whether therefore ye eat or drink, or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31, King James Version. Introduction. America stands on the brink. It stands on the brink because of government overspending and our colossal national debt. It stands on the brink because of manipulation, failed regulations, and predatory trading on our financial markets. It stands on the brink because of terrorism threats and covert moves against us by hostile foreign powers. But to take down our economy and eliminate the United States as a superpower, as many of our enemies seek to do, all these things will have to come together in a perfect storm. Something close to that occurred in September 2008, when our enemies hammered the U.S. economy in a stealth financial attack. That attack, and the likelihood that we'll be hit again in the near future, is the story of Secret Weapon. For too long, the warning signs have been clear. On September 11, 2001, our enemies hit the American homeland, and some evidence suggests they preceded that attack by short-selling U.S. airlines and other financial stocks. This was merely the latest and most obvious attack on the economic infrastructure of the United States. After all, Osama bin Laden had been vowing for years to take down the American economy, and he targeted the World Trade Center buildings precisely because of their importance, both actual and symbolic, in the financial world. This strategy was nothing new. For hundreds of years, nations, as well as terrorist groups, have understood the importance of attacking their enemies' economies. The United States is no exception. We engaged in economic warfare against the Soviet Union during the Cold War, against the British during the Suez Canal Crisis in 1956, against the Germans and the Japanese during World War II, and against the South during the Civil War. Our enemies did the same. Economic warfare is as real and can be just as devastating to a nation's security as a shooting war. Our enemies' attempts to wage economic warfare against us, however, never met with much success. Certainly, financial terrorism never did, at least not until September 2008, when America's financial infrastructure took a major hit and then crumbled. Over the course of the next few months, an estimated $50 trillion of global wealth simply evaporated, with more than a quarter of that sum disappearing from the United States. The media rushed to assign blame for the resulting economic crisis. Liberals pointed the finger at Wall Street fat cats, while conservatives faulted federal regulations that pressured financial companies to undertake risky loans. Democrats blamed Republicans. Republicans blamed Democrats. Nobody blamed the true culprits, America's foreign enemies. Many Americans believe that our physical infrastructure may be vulnerable to terrorism, but that our economy is somehow immune from attack. We like to think our stock market is just that, our stock market, and that our banks are American-made, American-funded, and American-run. No foreign enemy could sabotage our entire economy. That's the conventional wisdom. Not only is that perspective dangerously naive, it's downright wrong. Today's global economy is deeply interconnected, and like all interconnected industries and modes of technology, airlines, trains, the internet, it can be exploited by terrorists and other malevolent actors. History is filled with examples of financial attacks on companies, industries, and nations for both economic and non-economic ends. In the coming pages, we will pull the curtain back on the greatest untold scandal of the 21st century, the September 2008 financial attack on America. We begin by discussing the 9/11 atrocity and the little-known financial and economic aspects of the attacks. As authors Philip J. Cooper and Claudia Maria Vargas observe, Al-Qaeda envisioned 9/11 as a serious attack intended to produce massive casualties and serious damage to the economy. But it was also very much designed to be a symbolic assault, one that would strike the symbols of U.S. economic, political, and military power. We then recount my involvement with the issue of economic warfare and financial terrorism, and how I was recruited by the Pentagon to author a report on the possibility of such action being taken against the United States. As a longtime financial industry insider, my interest in this topic was virtually nil, until I discovered signs that short selling was being used as a market weapon prior to the financial collapse of September 2008. From there, we proceed to the biggest question of the last decade: who was behind that collapse? In any crime, prosecutors look for three elements: motive, means, and opportunity. We will examine each in turn.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.